Arizona State Police released a new footage in the case of a Filipino accused of attempting to murder her husband. Our North America correspondent Len Almadin Thornhill reports.
It was this home surveillance video, date stamped July 18, showing Melody Feliciano Johnson pouring liquid into a small bottle from what appears to be a bleach container, then going to the kitchen and pouring the contents into a coffee maker that prompted Tucson police to arrest the Filipino mother. The 39-year-old has been charged with multiple felonies, including attempted first-degree murder, for allegedly trying to poison her Air Force worker husband, Robbie Johnson.
Okay, about 50 minutes ago, while I was at work, I noticed her come over to the coffee maker and she did something. So I've got my tester. I'm going to add the water to see if there's chlorine and pH is off.
That's Robbie narrating on video the steps he took to show proof, he told the police, that his wife of 17 years was trying to kill him. ABS-CBN News obtained from Tucson police multiple videos that show Melody pouring liquid into a coffee maker and Robbie testing the water several times in July.
Like I do every day, I clean this thing out after I test it. This back is very slippery right now from after I rinsed. It smells like bleach.
Lawyer Josephine Escalante, who reviewed the videos, says people should be reminded not to quickly jump to conclusions.
The video of Mr. Johnson purportedly testing for bleach itself, it's really hard to say what's going on there. We have him telling us what he's doing, but we don't really know what that test strip is. We don't really know what substance is in there that he's purported to test.
Robbie, who works at Davis-Monthan Air Force Base, told Tucson police he suspected his wife has been tampering with his coffee since March, after he told her he filed for divorce. In court documents, police said they found liquid inside the coffee maker that smelled like bleach. Escalante points out that there is still a way for Melody's defense attorney to discredit the videos.
If the defense can show, by either putting Mr. Johnson on the witness stand and asking him about what's being shown in the video, if the defense can poke holes in what's being shown, if the defense can show that these videos were occurring at different times, so it's going to put the credibility of the evidence into question.
Melody remains at the Pima County Jail in Arizona on a $250,000 bond. The prosecutor secured a high bond from the court, citing that Melody is a flight risk, as she has a family and recently purchased a house in the Philippines. Melody Johnson's next court hearing is on November 6. Len Almadin Thornhill, ABS-CBN News.
The Immigration Bureau eyes using body cameras to address rising complaints against their personnel. Immigration spokesperson Dana Sandoval says the agency is in the process of procuring the body cameras, which screening officers can use by the end of the year.
Meron pong live streaming feature para namomonitor po ng office ni Commissioner what's actually happening on the ground. And maiiwasan po natin yung mga complaints about illegal actions, halimbawa ng mga employees o kaya naman po yung hindi mabuting pakikitungo ng ating mga empleyado.
The agency has also resumed the procurement of electronic gates for use in the country's international airports.
An opposition House lawmaker wants President Marcos to give up a portion of his confidential and intelligence funds for 2024. Congressman Edsel Lagman wonders whether Marcos would voluntarily relinquish some of his funds following a similar move by the offices of the Ombudsman and the Solicitor General. The Office of the President is seeking 4.5 billion pesos in confidential funds for next year.
A cybersecurity advocacy group urges lawmakers to allocate more funds to government agencies to help them combat cyber attacks. Ronald Gustilo of Digital Pinoy says the recent data breach in PhilHealth and the PSA show cybersecurity is not a state priority. He adds the ICT department should set standards for cybersecurity infrastructure across all government agencies. Gustilo also believes the government should also compensate victims of the data leaks.
I think the current the recent incidents of data breaches have is an eye opener for all of us now. Kasi it truly shows the current state of our cybersecurity infrastructure here in our country, especially for our government, that it seems that it's not among the priorities of the government. So I think it's high time that the government spends more of its budget to protect the data of the public. I'm really hoping that this is the last of it. But then again, knowing how the internet works and how technology works, this could not be the last. But since the budget deliberations is still not over, maybe our good senators and our good congressmen can compel these agencies, and maybe they can allocate more budgets for critical agencies that are holding huge amounts of data to undertake, to procure cybersecurity infrastructure to implement stiffer cybersecurity measures to protect our data. Kasi if they will not do that, if these agencies won't do that, eh talagang this would not be the last of it.
The Philippine Information and Technology Department also saying the data breach at the PSA is not as sophisticated as the attack on PhilHealth. According to DICT Undersecretary Jeffrey D, initial investigations showed the hackers are likely based in the Philippines. D adds his agency still hopes to receive an intelligence fund to uncover any other possible data breach. Earlier this week, an ad hoc House committee stripped the DICT of its confidential fund for next year.
Sa ngayon, ang alam namin ay yung nakompromiso ay yung laman ng community-based monitoring system. At nandito po, sinasubmit ang kanilang mga regional offices yung mga survey form. So ibig sabihin, nung household survey, nung papasok ang mga taga-PSA, magkatanong ng mga informasyon sa iyo. Sino ang head of the family, ilan kayo, ano income ninyo, no, mga ganon.